representing the same species. They're both sampled from the same distribution, which is the distribution of that species. Well, guess what? We get the same result. I don't show it here, but they're significantly similar. And these are two different metrics of niche identity. And in both cases, you see that the arrow, the observed, is to the left of the null distribution. And so they are less similar than you would expect by chance. And so once again, these two sets of points sampled from the same species are not identical to one another. So finally, and I've already given you some of the logic behind this paper, finally, as a result of writing a book with Enrique and Richard and a couple other colleagues, and as a result of a bunch of debates with Jorge Soberón, we come to kind of a painfully simple understanding of this. Here is a single niche. It's an ellipsoid in the cloud of North American climates. Okay, it's the same trick we play over and over again. And here is the footprint of that niche. And we're going to study it in these two squares of equal size. And what you can see is, here is our fundamental niche, that ellipsoid, and here is its representation within those two squares. Okay? But notice that the red square has better representation up here than the blue square does. And so now we're going to use those same inertia analyses that you saw in the Brenneman et al. Paper. And you see here's one, and here's the other, and they're not identical, and the difference is statistically significant. So what I've just kind of shown you three different ways is that you can take ecological niches that definitely should be the same. They're either a single virtual niche, or they're sampled from the same real species biological niche. And yet, because of regional differences in their representation, guess what? They're not identical. So that similarity metric may be more biologically meaningful, and the identical metric, the identity metric, seems to be perhaps overly powerful. So, remember this equation. Now I can show you exactly what happened. Here's that fundamental niche, which I held constant in each of those comparisons. Okay? Explicitly, I said, this is the same fundamental niche. But this is what you can observe. Okay? This is what we're able to estimate, unless we're really, really careful and really, really lucky, that existing fundamental niche is what we're getting out of these models, because it's the fundamental niche relative to the environments available to the species. And so what you can see is that if this is the only thing you can observe, and if this is constant, then all of that variation is coming out of either M or S, and not out of the fundamental niche. Another way of putting this is that we find niches to be different. That may be a consequence of real evolved niche difference. It may be a consequence of different representation of environments across the accessible area, or it may be a consequence of different sampling of environments. Okay? So, where do we come out of this? Niches do evolve. Okay. However, they don't evolve terribly easily, quickly, at least given the weight of evidence so far. At least for vertebrates and the invertebrate examples that we've looked at so far, they're frequently conserved out to hundreds of thousands of years, don't see any evidence for associations between speciation and niche innovation. So no overriding evidence for what's called ecological speciation. Remember, I'm talking about coarse grain environmental dimensions. The evidence for or against niche conservatism has frequently been overinterpreted. And really what we want is rigorously tested, well-established examples of niche change. Because those would be fascinating. Those would be really, really spectacular. But we have to get rid of the examples that are probably just consequences of methodological artifact. Okay? So these are ideas that probably many people would say are particular to me and a bit extreme. Okay? What I'm saying to you is that ecological niches do not change easily, and that speciation does not occur to be triggered by or a trigger of niche change. And a lot of people would disagree with me. I'm simply presenting an overview of what evidence exists, especially structuring that overview temporally. And I'm simply testing to make sure that there aren't methodological, non-biological explanations for